You ready to take your last breath, girl?
2 days and you're dead.
Leave me alone.
Oh, why don't you pray?
Nothing can save you now. Stop!
I wish we could just get rid of her.
The time will come.
I'm counting down the days. Just looking at her makes me sick.
Mom's delicious, thank you.
You're lucky we even invited you to dinner.
We have 5 new mares booked to Cats on Fire.
I told you'd be a profitable stallion.
I'll say. At $5,000 a pop, we'll make our money back and then some on his first crop alone.
May I please be excused?
No. Yes. The table isn't going to clean itself.
May I please be excused to my room?
Go. You need all the beauty rest you can get.
Only 4 more days till summer vacation. We'll have the whole summer to write. What would I do without you? Ooh, I gotta go. Have a good day, Lucky.
You all right? He literally does that every time he stops. Don't know why he doesn't wait until everyone's safely seated.
I think that's everything. There you are.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Totally have some exciting news.
Me too.
Okay, you go first.
I dropped my books on the bus this morning.
That doesn't really sound too exciting.
Let me finish. This really cute guy helped me pick them up.
Okay, tell me more. What's his name?
I don't know. He was wearing a varsity jacket.
Okay, so he probably plays sports. He's a senior. Did you catch his name on his jacket?
No. School's out Friday. He'll probably graduate and I'll never see him again.
Okay, let's just hope he's a junior that's really awesome at sports.
Who are they making fun of now? Anyway, what is your news?
Oh, yeah, last night, something changed. I feel like I finally know Jesus.
Jesus?
Jesus Christ, the savior of the world. Really, Lisa?
Oh, sorry, congratulations. I mean, what does that really mean?
That I received Jesus into my heart.
Into your heart?
Yeah, my Sunday school teacher and I had this really long talk, and I was telling her how I didn't really get the whole Jesus thing, and she said that's because I didn't get my gift.
Gift? Well, if it's that cute boy from the bus, I'll take it.
Lisa, I'm serious. I want you to come with me to youth group tomorrow night.
I don't know. I'd rather ride Lucky.
It'll be fun, I promise.
I don't know.
Okay, just promise me you'll think about it. Okay?
Okay.
Okay.
I'll think about it.
Okay.
Here's your list of chores.
I'll never have time to ride Lucky.
That's your problem.
Sorry, we couldn't go on a ride today.
Bridgestone's really scary. You know, you have to be careful. Satan is real, and he can make people do horrible things. And you're sure it wasn't a dream?
I don't know. Maybe I did dream it. I mean, I was half asleep when I walked into the house. I don't really know what I saw.
So I guess that means you didn't think about it.
What?
Youth crew? Please come with me tonight. It'll be a lot of fun.
Tina, I don't know. Can we talk about it later? I have a lot on my mind.
Yeah. Call me before 6 and my parents and I will come pick you up. Okay?
My parents have been listening on my calls. It's really weird. I don't know how they'd feel about me going to church. I mean, not really religious.
You can just say that you want to come and hang out in my house. They don't really have to know where we're going. And we drive right by your house on the way to church anyway. Where is Lucky? Where is Lucky?
Gone.
What do you mean, gone?
He's no longer here. We sold him.
Sold him? To who? Why would you do that? Where is Dad? Where is Lucky?
Calm down.
Calm down? You really expect me to be calm? Where is my horse?
We had to sell him to make room for the new stallions.
Sell him to who?
I don't know exactly who. Ask your mother.
How could you do this to me? Tina?
Are you okay? What's wrong?
My parents sold Lucky.
How could they? They know how much you love your horse.
Something isn't right. Can you please come get me?
Yeah, sure. We'll be right over.
We'll meet you by the gate.
Okay, see you with you.
Thank you for picking me up.
I'm just glad you called.
You're always welcome, sweetie.
We love having you around.
This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it
shine. Tina! Hi! This is my best friend, Lisa.
Hi, Lisa. My name's Sunshine.
I'm Eddie. Yeah.
I know you.
I'm Jason.
Lisa.
Yeah. Are your knees all right from the bus?
Oh, yeah, it's more my wrist, actually.
Honestly, you totally pulled it off. It looked pretty cool.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah.
I didn't see you on the bus this morning.
Yeah. Yeah, normally I don't take the bus. My dad usually drops me off on his way to work.
Anyways, welcome to youth group. Yeah.
Are you okay? That's the boy from the bus.
Jason.
Yeah.
Please take your seat so we can get this thing started.
All right, let's pray.
Lord, give me the right words to say. Open hearts, ears, and minds. And in Jesus' name, amen. Okay, so last week we left off on Satan. Satan comes in many different forms and can cause people to do things that they normally wouldn't do. His main goal is to take as many humans as possible with him to eternal punishment in hell. But he can only do that by preventing us from knowing and believing in God's plan of redemption. And we see later on in 1 Peter, we can actually notice that, Lisa.
What do you mean, redemption?
Oh, okay.
God, right, in his infinite love and wisdom, sent his son, Jesus Christ, to earth to live a perfect and sinless life. And Jesus then died on the cross for our sins, and 3 days later, he rose from the dead. If you believe that in your heart and confess that with your lips, then you'll be redeemed.
How do I do that?
You just have to pray. Ask the Lord to come into your heart.
And believe that he died for your sins and rose again.
Do you believe that, Lisa?
Let's do it. Thank you so much, Lord, for bringing Lisa in today. Lisa trusts and believes that you are her Savior. Holy Spirit, we feel your presence in this room right now. Love her and protect her. Guide her with whatever gifts you bestow upon her, Lord. Fill her up, Jesus. And in Jesus' mighty name, amen.
Amen. Amen.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
All right. This is for you.
Thank you.
Yeah, no problem. We have an after-school Bible study, and you should come.
What's the matter, Lisa?
You don't see them? They're right there in the middle of the parking lot.
See whom?
She can see us.
Perhaps that's her special gift. Let's depart quickly so we can report this.
They're gone now.
Who's gone? I didn't see anyone.
How could you miss them?
What do they look like?
They were both really tall. They had glowing white eyes.
Okay. Well, anything else unusual happens, just let us know. I'll be on the bus tomorrow, so I'll see you then. See you guys later.
Mom, you will never guess what happened.
Did Lisa accept the Lord?
How did you know?
Just had a feeling. Congratulations, sweetie. And welcome to the family. It was more than just that. Something weird happened.
Thank you, Mrs. Lynch. Did any of you see anything weird when you were saved?
Your life's been changed, Lisa. You've been made anew. Things may seem different, but you can never go wrong trusting Jesus.
God is good.
All the time.
All the time, God is good.
Belial, look at this. I think that girl can see us.
You're crazy, Jeriah. Humans can't see demons.
This one can. See how she follows my movements with her eyes?
Hey, I think you're right.
Possess her.
Now it's your turn.
What's this?
Bible.
A Bible? You disgust me. I never want to see this book again.
I'll be a little late coming home.
And don't forget to muck the stalls. Lazy girl.
I was thinking about you last night.
You were?
About your gift.
Oh.
Did anything else happen after we saw you last night?
Yeah, my parents are demon-possessed.
You're serious? Okay. Cool.
I think one of them tried to possess me, too. When it touched me, it screamed as if I burnt it.
Okay, well, the good news is once you're saved, you can't be possessed, so. All right, I'll see you after school in room 305.
Yeah, I won't miss.
What's up?
The bus driver.
What about the bus driver?
His eyes.
Maybe writing things down would be helpful.
The mystery is solved, huh?
What do you mean?
About Jason being the mysterious boy from the bus, silly.
Three more
what?
Three more demon-possessed kids.
How do you know?
They have yellow eyes, and they're throwing these things at people's heads.
Throwing things?
They look like marbles.
Are you feeling okay? Mm-hmm.
That's weird.
You're weird.
Mr. Jenkins, Mr. Howard, Mr. Radigari, and six students. Also, I saw demons in the hallway throwing flaming marbles at people's heads.
Lisa, I've been giving this a lot of thought, and Lisa.
They're here.
Who?
Have no fear, Lisa.
I think they're friendly.
Fear not. We mean you no harm. We are angels of the Lord of Hosts. My name is Vinaya, and this is Tirsa.
What is happening to me? Why am I the only one who can see and hear you? People are starting to think I'm crazy.
You have been given a special gift, for you are the key to reclaiming Cloverville.
Reclaiming Cloverville? From what?
I think you already know from what. Jason has been called to full-time service by the Lord of Hosts. If you two put your heads together, I'm sure you can figure out what to do.
Now, go back to your friends and let us observe.
Elisa, what just happened? Who are you talking to?
Angels. They want to be left alone.
What did they say to you?
That I've been given a special gift of seeing angels and demons to reclaim Cloverville.
Reclaim it from what?
They said that you've been called to full-time service by the Lord of Hosts and we could figure it out ourselves.
Called? No one knows about that, all right? Only Pastor Emery knows about that.
I don't even know what called means.
It means I feel like God has asked me to become a pastor.
A pastor?
Yeah.
He's gonna be celibate.
Pastors can't get married, can they?
Oh, she's on a roll now.
Hey, I thought you were supposed to just observe.
Sorry, couldn't help myself.
I'm out of here. This is way too weird for me.
Dude, this is like a freak show or something.
Me too, I'm going with you guys.
Are you guys gonna leave?
I'm staying with you.
Look, Jason.
Are you sure about this?
Yeah.
Lisa, there's actually a precedent in the Bible for your gift. It's in 2 Kings.
You don't think I'm crazy?
Well, to be honest, yeah, I did a little, but once you mentioned I was called, no. Here, it talks about an army of thousands surrounding the city of Dothan and ready to slay the prophet Elisha. Elijah's servant was scared, but they told him not to worry because there was this invisible warrior army that was way stronger than the enemy. My point is that the servant, even though he had human eyes, could see this invisible angel army. My opinion, if I'm allowed to have one, is that whatever you're seeing in this room are angels, and the ones with the yellow eyes are demons, and the marbles are just like the fiery darts that are in the book of Ephesians.
Looks like we're on the right track.
There has been a lot of those new age stores opening up in town recently. I wonder if that means something.
You mean the ones with magic in the psychic bookstores? One of my friends was talking about some crystals that she got from there.
Actually, I've noticed some kids in my English class, they've been playing with tarot cards, and it's been kind of creeping me out.
Yeah, people have been acting differently since those stores popped up.
Maybe we should check it out. What's the most popular one?
The kids kept talking about the Life Force store and how it's the newest place in town to hang out.
We should start there. Maybe that will explain what's happening to me.
Okay. Lisa and I will visit the Life Force store on Saturday, and then on Sunday, we'll let you guys know what's up.
Keep us in your prayers.
Are you feeling okay?
I don't know. I'm kind of worried about going home.
You know, you can always ask God for protection.
How do I ask him?
Through prayer. Prayer is like a conversation with God. Basically, you talk to him and you wait and listen for his response.
Is that the same as when the angels speak to me?
I mean, most of us don't really have angels talking to us, but yeah, God speaks to us when we're silent in prayer or when we read the Bible. Come on. Dear Lord Jesus, I just pray for Lisa's protection, that you'll always be with her, and that you will be with her when she gets home.
Where have you been, Lisa?
I'm sorry, I told Mom I'd be late.
This is Mr. and Mrs. Newman. Mr. Newman is the chairman of the Cloverville City Council.
It's nice to meet you, Lisa.
Nice to meet you both as well.
Lisa, my hands are almost healed from last night. Want a rematch?
I thought you said she could heal us and see us.
She can.
Mom, can I please have a piece of pie?
No. You don't get dessert. You didn't eat dinner.
This is a waste of time.
The boss, you gotta believe me.
No more false reports, Bilal.
Or you know what awaits you. Tell him, Julia. You saw it first.
Perhaps you were mistaken.
You are wasting my time.
Please excuse us. Mrs. Newman and I must
Miss your delicious dessert. I have a meeting to attend to and we must get going.
Businessman after my own heart. I'm sorry you have to go. I'll walk you out.
You'll never guess who came for dinner last night.
Satan? Probably not the best joke to make. Sorry.
Actually, it was four demon-possessed humans. And one of them was Mr. Newman.
Chairman of the city council.
You know him?
Yeah, my father's on the city council. Hey!
Congratulations, sweetheart.
Thanks, Mama. Thanks.
We have a surprise for you.
What? Is this me? Wow. Wow. Thank you, guys. This is...
Well, it was either this truck or the University of Oregon, which gave that scholarship up.
Thanks, Dad.
We are proud of you, honey.
Thanks, Mama. All right. You two want to share my first ride with me?
I already rode over in it. You guys go ahead.
All right, come on. My lady.
Hi.
Sunshine! She promised me she'd give me back after what we did at summer camp. Hey, you're the worst!
That sounds like a story I need to hear.
Yeah, maybe after we clean all this up. This is perfect.
There's a big dumpster in the back. We can toss out all this confetti. Yeah,
that's exactly what I was thinking. That looks like a body, right?
I think that's Mr. Newman's car.
I don't see Mr. Newman.
That's...
Put your head up.
Was definitely his car.
Let's go see what they dumped in there.
Do you think we should be doing this?
What if there is someone in that rug? They need our help.
Let's hope there isn't. Wait, Jason. I'm scared.
God, this is disgusting.
That's Principal Hodges.
Put your hands up.
Whoa, hey.
Get over there. Put your hands up.
Hey, can you put your gun down, please?
What'd you put in that dumpster?
I didn't put anything in the dumpster. Put your guns down, man.
We were just dumping out the confetti that was in the truck.
Cuff him.
You got a lot of explaining to do.
But we didn't do anything wrong. Ask Mr. Newman. It was his car we saw driving away.
What did you say? Mr. Newman? He's one of the most respected men in this town. Read him their rights.
Let's go. Yo, I want to make my phone call, all right? My father's on the city council.
Later.
We have a right to a phone call.
I said later.
This is ridiculous. All right. Lisa, everything's going to be all right? Once I make this phone call, my father's going to bail us out.
This is all my fault.
How could you possibly think that?
I'm the one who suggested that we put the confetti into the dumpster, and now we're never going to get out of here.
Lisa, come on. All right?
Everything's gonna be fine.
Just glad that your girlfriend is in.
Girlfriend? Did you say girlfriend?
Yeah, sunshine.
People think that? No, okay, no. Sunshine is my sister.
Oh.
Yeah.
Thank God. I mean, she sounds like a very nice sister.
Yeah, she's nice. To be honest, I've never had like a real girlfriend. So.
I find that really hard to believe.
Why?
I mean, you're so.
What?
Nothing.
Yeah, I guess like trying to keep my grades up and football and church, of course. Just kind of got too busy. Anyway, don't worry, seriously. My dad's gonna get us out of here.
I'm not sure about that.
Lisa?
There's a demon in my room.
Hiram. I figured that little worm Belial was telling the truth. He's too stupid to come up with a story like that. But I had to see for myself.
What do you want?
I wanted to get you alone so I could explain how things really are. You chancing upon that dumpster was, shall we say, a convenient opportunity for me to isolate you.
What else do you want, Hiram?
You have been given a special gift from the Nazarene. For what purpose, I don't know. His ways are mysterious even to us. I am, however, demanding that you do not use this gift in Cloverville ever again.
I didn't ask for this sight, and I have no control over what I see.
True. But you can stop telling people what you see.
Lisa, what are the demons saying?
It wants me to stop telling people when I see them.
Silence! Haven't you understood a single word I've said? This is not a request. I am ordering you. Do not tell anyone what you see ever again. Or else.
Or else what?
Belial already tried to possess me. Maybe you should ask him how that turned out.
You do not know your Bible very well, human. Read the book of Job. It is true we cannot possess you, however. We can make you wish you were dead. I'm about to give you a short lesson in the power you are up against.
Lisa, what's going on? Lisa. Lisa, awaken.
The night will take you so long.
The powers of evil blocked our entrance.
What about Jason?
He will recover. Nothing is broken. Lisa, I have to go. Remember, if you need me, pray. May the spirit light your path.
You're released. Mr. Newman has vouched for you. Seems we don't have enough evidence to hold you. We'll bring your truck around front.
need to get to the bottom of this or I won't be able to sleep. I think we should go to that life force store tonight.
Are you sure you're feeling up to it?
They're going to keep attacking us if we don't, and I don't know if I can handle that again.
We should talk with Pastor Emery first. I bet he's still at the church. He usually meets up with my dad on Friday nights.
Chandler's been killing me lately. I'm gonna wash up.
Who is he?
Lisa, this is Nissan.
Hello, Nissan.
What is so funny?
Nissan's a car company.
Nissan is a very good name.
It is even one of the months on the Hebrew calendar.
I'm so sorry.
I'm the angel of this church.
What do you mean, angel of this church?
Well, every Christian church, town, city, and country for that matter has an angel watching over it.
Well, the angel of Cloverville should be fired. Oh, I'm so sorry, Tirsa. I had no idea.
We are limited by the empowerment that your prayers give the Lord of Hosts to act upon.
I shouldn't have said that. I didn't mean to hurt your feelings.
Although I do care deeply about what is happening in my Cloverville, feelings were not hurt, little one.
And what are you responsible for, Vinaya?
You.
Oh.
Now go get cleaned up. You wouldn't want to frighten the pastor and his guests.
We have known for a while now that something is very wrong here in Cloverville.
Wrong?
Well, evil, if I'm being candid.
The chairman of the city council probably has something to do with that. The head demon took over his body.
And that brings us to your special gift. Now, for some reason, God has seen fit to give you this new sight to help us reclaim Cloverville.
But how? Do you know what I'm supposed to do?
Unfortunately, I don't. We are, however, on your side. We'll do everything we can to help.
Before we were arrested, our plan was to go to the Life Force bookstore and see if we can figure anything out.
Good. Jason, you've been called to full-time ministry. This is, however, I'm afraid, your baptism by fire. Now, demons are territorial, and they will not give up Cloverville without a battle.
Pastor, if you wouldn't mind, I would like to be the point of contact for this investigation. I would like Jason to report to me, and then I'll compile all the facts and give a report to you and William.
Oh, I think that's a reasonable request. Let's pray before you go. Lord, we ask that you cover Jason and Lisa with your protection. Guide them to where they need to be to do your work and your will, Father. Thank you for your faithfulness, your protection, and your provision. In Jesus' name, amen.
People actually believe this stuff works?
Well, when people don't have Jesus in their lives, I'll try to fill that void with anything that sounds good to them. Satan is always ready to do whatever it takes to keep their eyes from the truth.
I don't know why, but I have a feeling that whatever we're looking for is behind those doors. We need to find a way to get back there somehow.
Maybe a distraction.
Do you think you could knock over that book rack? That'll buy me time to get to the back room.
I could, yeah. But wouldn't that be wrong? You know, like, we're the good guys, right?
Well, then what do you suggest?
Pray. Dear Lord, please help us figure out a distraction in order for us to get to that back room. Whatever you can, I'm trying to listen.
I found something.
What's up?
Meeting room A lower. What's A lower?
The library.
What?
It's the only place in town that uses uppers and lowers for the room numbers.
Let's see how good your Cisco's are.
Let's go.
Hello. I was wondering if I could show my girlfriend room A. She wants to host an equestrian night and wants to check the space out.
Upper or lower level?
Probably lower.
Room A is over to the right. Unfortunately, it's still a mess from last night's meeting. Our janitor quit 2 days ago.
Oh, that's a stinker. Well, honestly, I don't think we'll care too much about the mess, ma'am. Oh. Thank you.
Girlfriend.
Did I say that? Oh, man, I'm sorry. Must have slipped.
Nothing to be sorry about.
She wasn't lying.
Why would they leave it a mess like this?
That's a good point.
This stuff looks confidential.
We should take everything, just in case.
Up the room.
It's our civic duty.
It's nice to see young people taking responsibility.
Yep, uh-huh.
I need to speak to Mr. Newman.
Wow, your house is beautiful.
Yeah, it's just a house. My dad's a realtor.
I recognize some of these names from last night's council meeting.
What do these weird diagrams and words mean?
Mindless doodling.
Why were you meeting up at the library in the middle of the night and not the city council chambers?
That's city business. And all of these papers were supposed to have been cleaned up. Anyways, I don't see anything remotely sinister here.
Maybe we need to show Pastor Emery these papers. I mean, those words gotta mean something.
It's gibberish. You're grasping a straw, son. Now, I have to get back to work.
It's me. We need to talk.
You can stop here.
You want me to drive you up to your house?
Could we just sit here for a minute?
Yeah. Yeah, totally. Can I tell you a secret?
Sure.
Every day on the bus, I'm really happy you dropped your books. It's felt this total attraction to you.
I thought it was really sweet that you helped me. And to be honest, I felt this attraction to you, too.
Someone broke into my office.
Who would do that?
I didn't even take the laptop.
Should I call the cops?
No. Everything seems to be here. Except for that bag of papers from the library.
I bet Mr. Newman sent his men.
So, how's your date?
I mean, if you want to call it that.
I think you can make a cute couple.
Yeah, thanks.
Jason! Jason! We take out the trash?
Okay, Mom! Oh, man, I guess you'll just never know. It sucks.
Give me some details.
It was more than okay.
Jason?
Sorry for bothering you this late, Pastor, at your home, but I think this is important.
And for some reason, my dad said that the papers were stolen, but they were just in the trash. Pretty weird, right? And when I asked him earlier if I can come here, he said no. See anything of meaning over there?
Well, the papers that you found have mostly to do with a new construction project in Cloverville, but these two seem out of place.
What do you mean?
Well, one is a diagram and the other one is a list, both with Hebrew and Latin words on it.
Why do you think my father's trying to hide these papers?
I don't know. I'll ask him tomorrow. Anyway, it's getting late. Why don't you go home? I'll tackle this later.
Okay. Thank you. Good night.
Why did you throw away the papers that Jason and Lisa found?
Jason gave those to you.
What are you hiding?
Nothing sinister, I assure you.
Go on.
Those documents contain details of a new city project. Old newbie said it'd be better if the project didn't come to light just yet. So he advised me to tell Jason they were stolen so he'd forget about them.
Why would he say that?
What I'm about to tell you must not leave this office until it is made public. Agreed? As you know, the library has been in disrepair for years. Hardly anyone ever checks out books, and almost all the research is done online these days. So, we want to turn the library into a hotel.
This plan will have opposition.
That's the reason for the secrecy. We don't want word of this getting out until all the options can be worked through.
Well, I think we know now what happened.
Your secret is safe with us. Let the kids in. All right, all these papers will be destroyed. Except for these two. Now, these two have some interest. They have a lot of phrases in Latin and Hebrew inscribed on them.
What are those symbols?
Well, they seem to be a diagram of some sort with a lot of scribbled words in different languages. It'll take me some time to study these. However, this one
has some special interest. Now, obitus, that's a word that means death. Signum means marked.
Marked for death? My name is on there.
Don't worry, Lisa.
You're fifth on the list. Two below Mr. Hodges.
Mr. Hodges was murdered yesterday. Who is Mrs. O'Malley?
She fell down a flight of stairs at the library 5 months ago. She was a rich, elderly woman. Rumor had it that she was going back east to live with her sister.
I guess her death was no accident.
It was an accident. I saw the police report.
The police are in on this.
Or so she says.
In any case, who cares if she moved out of town? Why would that be a reason for her accident?
She was planning on cashing in all of her city bonds. It's that money that we used to fund the projects, like the new storefronts and the city improvements, and the city has no cash to pay her back.
So, with her out of the way, the bonds can't be cashed in and the city's free to use the money.
Normally, in this case, her family could still claim the bonds, but her found out her sister passed away before she did. Her sister was her last known family member.
It was an unfortunate accident.
But a lucky break for the city.
Next on the list is Mr. Green. How did Mr. Green die?
Car accident. The whole football team saw it. Missed his turn and straight to a fence and hit the goalpost. It's a terrible accident.
Well, at least we thought it was an accident.
So what's his connection to Cloverville?
This is ridiculous. You're all jumping to conclusions. They were all accidents.
Mr. Green owned the land adjacent to the Cloverville Library.
Area needed for a parking lot.
Coincidence.
Mrs. O'Malley, Mr. Green, Mr. Hodges, Mr. Gordon is next on the list. And then me.
We better notify the authorities.
The authorities? They're all in on this with Mr. Newman.
We gotta get out of Cloverville.
No one will believe us.
Three people on this list are already dead. Now surely that ought to mean something.
We should warn Mr. Gordon before he winds up dead too.
It's not too late, I'll go.
No. Let's let Lisa go check in on Mr. Gordon. I want you to go to the county sheriff up in Wairega. Now, it could be that with this list, he can be convinced that something's going on.
Assuming, of course, that he too hasn't been possessed with a demon.
Let's hope not.
What about me? I want to help.
I'm going to take you home.
I always miss out on all the fun.
Fun? Sunshine, this isn't a game, all right? Three people have already been murdered.
Met with accident.
Sunshine can come with me, if that's okay. We're just going to check on Mr. Gordon.
Please, Daddy? Since they were only accidents anyway?
Fine.
Thanks for the ride.
Yeah.
We can walk from here and I have to get to Eureka.
Be careful.
You too.
Come on. You guys can make googly eyes at each other later.
What should I say to Mr. Gordon? Like, hi, Mr. Gordon, you're on a death list, and I was just checking to see if you're still alive. If he comes to the door, then we know he's okay. Should we go in?
Isn't that against the law?
I'll stay out here. Call me if you need me.
Mr. Gordon? I'm not staying out here by myself. I'm coming with you. Mr. Gordon? triples. What?
What? Sunshine, don't scream like that. It's a dead body.
You scared me.
He doesn't have a pulse. Can we get out of here now? There's blood on that knife.
The murder weapon.
No, Sunshine, don't touch it. We need to go. Split up. Run straight in that direction. So he's got the first one on the left, okay? That's where I meet you. Go.
Stop! Don't move. Sarge, you don't want to see this.
Sunshine? Sunshine, are you here? Sunshine? What's so funny?
Your boyfriend's sister has been caught and is in jail.
Belial. Tell Hiram I will give myself up to him if he lets Sunshine go.
She'll be okay.
Sunshine's where?
She's in jail. She's charged with murder.
Who are they saying she killed?
Mr. Gordon. They caught her at the crime scene with blood on her hands.
Come on, Dad. All right, Mr. Gordon was next on the list, and you know that. I had nothing to do with this.
Wait, okay. What?
That means Lisa's next.
There's more of the McGrath girl's fantasies.
Jonas, what is going
on? Are you kidding me right now? They're obviously not fantasies, Dad. All right, Lisa is telling the truth, unlike you.
Watch it, son.
No, you lied when you said the office was broken into.
I did that for Cloverville. And you went behind my back and gave those papers to Pastor Emery.
Yeah, and I did that for Cloverville.
Cut it out, you two.
I just can't believe you right now. Hey, why haven't you bailed Sunshine out yet?
No bail has been set. It's the weekend. We can't even see her until Monday.
Monday. Great. Where's Lisa?
Lisa's the one who called us. She's safe.
This is all that McGrath girl's fault. That coward is sitting safely at home while your sister is in a cell!
Her name is Lisa! Okay, she's not a coward! You don't know anything about her.
I'm so sorry.
I know.
I told Belial I'll give myself up to Hiram if he lets Sunshine out of jail.
No. No, you can't. All right, you're on his death list. He'll murder you.
There's no other way. Sunshine is innocent. I can only imagine how scared she must be in there right now. It should have been me.
Lisa, there has to be another way. All right, let's talk with Pastor Emery first. Lisa, I just found you. I don't want to lose you.
I'm not sure about that White Rica sheriff. He took notes and he said he'd get back to me, but nothing.
The only way for us to get Sunshine out of jail is for me to surrender myself to Hiram.
Oh, absolutely not. You will never surrender to a demon.
I'm not going to give myself up to Hiram.
What did you say? We already told Hiram about your deal.
I changed my mind.
How dare you go back on your word!
You are not authorized to do that. Hiram wants to take her blood at the Letha Summit.
But she got us in trouble with Hiram again.
Go away now. Do your chores, you backstabbing liar.
It will be a pleasure to watch.
Amen? Let's pray. Father, thank you for this beautiful day. Bless each one that was in church today and protect them as they go about doing your will this day and this week. You are so faithful, Father. Thank you for your love and your presence here today. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
That would be great. I would really appreciate that.
Oh, Lisa, I want you to meet Mr. Foma. He's agreed to help us.
It's nice to meet. Pastor, may I speak to you alone?
Oh, sure. Please excuse us for a moment, gentlemen.
I think he might be an angel. His eyes were glowing white.
Mr. Foma, Lisa has noticed something odd. And before we proceed, we need to get her observation clarified.
Continue.
Lisa informs me that you are not what you would appear to be, something of the supernatural order?
It's true. I'm an angel, sent to free the girl.
And free our town from the demons?
No, I'm afraid that is your task. My assignment is to free the girl.
Why did the Lord send an angel to free Sunshine?
Hiram has overstepped his limits. The Lord has allowed Satan to give humans a choice, but Hiram has begun a campaign to enslave humans.
Well, Mr. Foma, how can we help?
Hiram has no legal right to take the girl without first gaining permission. Hiram has been, shall we say, bending the rules by breaking angelic law.
So, what happens now?
I must first meet with Hiram. If he chooses to cease and desist, then you will not be taken to heavenly court.
What do you want us to do?
Do what you've been doing. Pray and follow the path that's set before you. Have faith, Jonas.
Thank you for helping my daughter.
I think we should pray. William, would you lead us in prayer?
Lord, use this gentleman to free Sunshine. Guide Lisa and Jason as they follow your path in saving our town. Please protect them and watch over them. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen.
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 Mr. Newman's demon, Hiram, has been imprisoned in the abyss.
How do you know?
While you were praying, Vinaya came in and told me of a heavenly trial.
Oh, he just came in here and told you, did he?
Gentlemen and lady, Hiram has been found guilty and sent to the abyss.
Does that mean my daughter's free?
Yes. Sunshine is being processed for release as we speak.
Is that right? Well, I don't believe you. I'm gonna go down there right now and see for myself.
May the spirit light your path.
Nothing is impossible with God. I think we've had more than enough excitement for one morning. We shall go.
Wait, I have one question first. What does Litha mean?
Where did you hear that word?
I overheard Belial saying I was not to be killed until the Litha Sabbath.
That's the witch's summer solstice celebration.
Summer solstice is on Tuesday.
That's only 2 days away.
When we're finished here, I'm going to go back and study the chart that you found at the library. Now, it may hold the key. In the meantime, you should ask Vinaya to stay close by you.
Dead.
Yes. Unconscious, I guess.
There's six demons on the deck arguing about something.
This turned into a pretty interesting Sunday.
Next in line.
I am. You are nothing more than a mere foot soldier, Javaya, and that is all that you will ever be.
My circle is prospering the best. I should replace Hiram. Adar, my circle has grown from 3 to 12 witches and warlocks in 3 weeks. I am the greatest.
You sure are quiet, Belial. Don't you want to be boss?
I think we should vote on it.
Vote? Are you crazy?
You've been amongst the humans far too long, Belial. We shall settle this as we always have. A fight. No weapons, no armor. The last one standing shall be the new boss. That is our way. That is the way Hiram received his rank. And that is the way I, the mighty Thayer, shall receive my...
Hello?
Hello?
Lisa, Pastor Emery said he found something that you need to see. He's at the library. My dad and I will pick you up, okay?
No, you can't come right now. It's too dangerous. There's a horde of demons fighting in my backyard.
Are you okay?
Yeah, Jason's here. We need to get to the library. Pastor Emery found something.
Must we continue? You submit to my authority.
Best you do, God.
Do you submit?
Yes. I swear to your allegiance.
And the rest of you. Javier. Belial. Malak. Shimon.
There are no other challenges. Submit to me.
I swear on
you. It's you and the world. In 2 nights, the Midsummer celebration takes place. We have gathered many animals for sacrifice, but we are missing one important thing. The McGrath girl. Capture her. Alive. I want to kill her myself.
Hold on.
Adar will be my second, since he alone had the courage to fight me. Thank you, boss. Recruit a new demon to possess the police sergeant. I will not return to that body. I will possess the human called Newman. He has the most power in this town.
Yes, boss.
Also, that human that helped Hiram. I have no use for him. See to it that he is taken out of the way.
Yes, boss.
We need to go. The demons are almost finished.
There she is. Get her!
No!
Lisa! Lord, forgive me. I'm sorry about your parents back there. My adrenaline kicked in. Are you okay?
Those weren't my parents.
Look after Lisa. She's been through a lot.
Hey.
Lisa, are you okay?
Did you get up to Wairika?
Yep.
Anything?
Yep.
Thank you for meeting me here.
Oh, good. You found him. I've deciphered the words on the paper you found. Now, Lisa, see if this makes any sense to you. Now, I've translated the words again with the English meaning next to them. What is it, Lisa?
These are the names of demons. Dagon, Savaya, Belial, Moloch, Shimon, and all the rest. These are all names of demons I've heard.
Well, you don't seem to be any order on that list you gave me.
Wait, this is a map.
Map? It just looks like a bunch of lines.
No, this long road, this is the long road goes to my house. And this is the church. And here's the high school.
Yeah, I see it too. That's our house.
I don't understand these words.
Those are the words that you read in the original language. Look at the translations that it wrote on.
Where does Mr. Newman live?
Well, that's a good question.
Here, this circle.
That makes perfect sense because Hiram's name is written right next to it. Where does Mr. Jenkins live?
Oh, the vice principal.
He's a temporary principal now, after Mr. Hodge's accident.
I know where he lives. Here.
So he's possessed by Shimon.
It's like they're each in charge of a different area in town.
I heard the demons talking about circles.
That's interesting. Circles is another name for covens.
The demons were bragging to each other about how many witches and warlocks they'd grown their circles by.
Demons? Witches, covens, for real? Like here in Cloverville?
What does all this mean?
Maybe I can get some guidance. If we pray with the names of specific demons in specific places, could you do anything about it?
Once the demon is out of the body, we can fight them. But if the demon is still inside the body, we are helpless.
I have a plan. The angels can't fight the demons when they're possessing a body. But when the demon is out of the body, then they can fight them. We need to make a group of people to go exorcise the demons and a group to stay at the church and pray. Tina, call the youth group and see who can come to church and pray. And Mr. Lynch, call the congregation to see who can come as well.
Jason and I will go to the homes with you to perform the exorcisms.
Great. I can take my car. Jason!
Hey!
Is everything all right?
Yeah, I was just rethinking that scholarship. I just want to talk to you about it.
Oh yeah, come on in.
Cool.
So, University of Oregon.
Go Ducks!
Oh, how rude of me. My wife would normally get you all drinks, but she's not here right now. Can I get anyone anything to drink?
You know?
Shimon, I know you're in there. We're here to get you out.
There's a bounty on your head!
He's not possessed! Having a seizure!
He's just possessed! Don't just hold him down!
You will pay for this! They're gonna set us on the cannon!
In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I command Shimon to come out of this man!
Lisa! Lisa, are you okay? Just breathe. Just breathe.
I'm okay. But I killed the demon.
Just breathe. You alright? Easy.
I told you you'd go pro.
I had no control. That thing had full control over me. Things I said, things I did. I said to my wife, my kids, all that I put them through.
Give it time. I'll take it with you tomorrow.
Listen. Until now, I thought all this was a fantasy. I'm sorry. Son, I should have never doubted you. Faster than I remember.
Excuse me. Can I help you?
Mrs. Newman, is Mr. Newman home?
Is he expecting you?
Yeah.
Daggum! Avner, what are you doing here? Shouldn't you be out making your rounds?
Sorry for the interruption, boss, but I have something you'll definitely want to hear.
Well, spit it out!
Shimon is in the abyss.
How?
I was making my rounds, collecting wandering dogs and cats, when I heard Shimon's death scream. Then I saw that McGrath girl leaving his home.
By herself?
No. The one remaining pastor was with her, and a couple other humans.
Who were they?
I don't know. I wanted to get out of there fast. Didn't want to be seen.
I want you to get the word out. Everyone is to be extra cautious, and I want everyone paired up.
Anything else, boss?
I want the McGrath girl captured tonight!
Attention, everyone. Thank you for coming out to pray. Well, we have a victory to report. One demon has been sent to the pit. Now, please continue to pray. We'll be leaving shortly for the next exorcism.
Sunshine, I'm so glad you're out of jail.
Me too.
I'm so sorry. I still feel like all of this is my fault. It should have been me instead of you.
No. If you would have been caught, they would have killed you.
All right, where to next?
Pastor Emery, I think Lisa should stay here while we go ahead.
What? No.
Pastor.
It's Lisa's decision to make.
Mr. Jenkins' demon already attacked you. You were its target.
And I was the only one who could see him.
Oh my God.
Without me, you're blind, which means you're both safer with me there.
No, it's not my safety I care about.
Me neither. There are a lot of names on this map. Two of them are my parents.
We going?
Here.
Report a kidnapping. I have a partial plate. They're in an animal control van.
Why? Why?
No! Let me go!
I know how scared he must be.
Hey. We got through this once, didn't we?
Did you find her?
Wasn't fast enough.
Something else.
Hey! Tell Sergeant Finney I want to talk to him.
The sergeant isn't in right now.
I called you, the police, and you arrested me? Oh, what kind of backwards public service is that?
You had a warrant out for your arrest. When you have a warrant, we bring you in. Doesn't matter if you're the one who called.
A warrant? For what?
Misappropriation of government funds. The affidavit was signed by the chairman and a fellow city council member.
I didn't know such thing. And they're lying.
The DA is going to send in a team to go through all of the city records.
Perfect. You know that will only prove my innocence. Hey, what about bail?
Your hearing's in 12 hours.
Lisa was right.
I knew he's not himself.
Tomorrow's the day. I can't stop thinking about her. It's gonna be impossible to find her. You know, she could be anywhere.
We need one of those police dogs that can pick up scents.
Dogs? Why did you have to say that? I miss Buster. He's still missing. Yeah. It's been 2 weeks now, and I don't think he's gonna come back.
I'm sorry, Eddie. My cat's been missing for a little over 2 weeks now. We thought maybe a coyote got to her.
It seems like there are a lot of missing animals right now.
Yeah. You're right, I saw like 2 dozen missing pet flyers on Lisa's fence the other day.
Wait, do you think that Lisa and the missing animals have something in common?
Like what?
I don't know, like, maybe they're going to sacrifice them too?
Hold up. Do you think Lisa and the missing animals are together?
Yeah. Yeah. Why else would the animals be missing?
My dog has a chip in its neck. Isn't that supposed to be used to find your pets? Better yet, aren't most dogs tagged with chips?
RFID chips, radio frequency identification microchips. Watch a lot of animal shows. Yeah, Scruffers has one too.
What's the range of the chips?
I don't know.
Me neither.
Maybe the vet knows.
We were wondering, how far can the RFID chips be detected?
That's not their purpose. They are used to identify your pet when they're found. Why are you concerned about range?
Okay, I'm just gonna be straight up with you. There's been a string of missing pets, and we're trying to find them, and we're hoping we can use the RFID chips to track them down.
Gabriella, can you pass me one of those GPS trackers, please?
This is our most popular one.
The collar goes around the pet, for dog owners mostly.
What's the range on them?
2 miles. Although this expensive collar can go up to 9 miles. And this little GPS receiver, it shows you the direction and the distance. The problem is the battery only lasts up to about 2 weeks.
Okay. By any chance, do you know anyone who bought the expensive collar and also has like lost a dog recently?
I see what you're trying to do.
Yeah.
Sadly, I really can't give out that information. You know, I wish I could help you, but I can't.
No, I understand.
Whoops. Jason, can you pick that up for me, please?
Yeah, sure.
Please be in touch.
Thank you. Thank you, doctor. Yeah. Let's go.
So what now?
Old Guns Dog Training Center on Mountaintop Road. That was the photo the doc had me have. Pick up. Hey, let's drop off the girls. Hi.
Hey.
We're wondering if you lost any dogs recently.
What's it to you?
There has been a bunch of missing animals lately, and we really need help finding them.
So you guys think I had something to do with that?
No, absolutely not.
Not at all. It's our understanding that if you had any dogs missing, that they might have a tracking collar on them. We can use that to hopefully find the other dogs.
Been there, done that, Sonny. And dogs are out of range.
I figured that. However, I think I might be able to get closer to their general location if I had your tracking device, and it could, like, you know, really narrow down the search.
Well, if you were able to find Gunner and Scout, there might be a big reward in it for you, because those are some valuable hunting dogs.
Cool. Can I get your tracking device?
Well, not without some collateral.
Okay. How about this? All right. If we can find
Gunner and Scout,
then we'll return them to you with no reward necessary.
Might be worth the risk. Oh, down here somewhere. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Now, this doohickey ain't worth nothing without those hunting dogs.
All right, cool. Thank you.
Hey, keep in mind, they've been gone for 2 weeks now. Those batteries are probably shot by now.
It's worth a shot, all right?
All right.
Thank you.
Good luck.
They've gotta be going to the sacrifices.
Let's go!
Careful, us.
We know who you are, lover boy.
This is perfect. You killed her boyfriend, let her watch.
Jason! No, please leave him alone. It's me you want, not him. Lord, please help us. And I owe you, please, Lord, we need you, please.
Easy. We gotta go.
What?
Easy.
Alright, I got you. Here we go.
It's over, Dagon.
Look who's coming to meet his doom. Shall we do this with honor? No weapons, a fight to oblivion. You will meet your end.
So be it.
Give up and stand before the heavenly court.
We know how that will end, and I prefer an even chance.
Remember, he's fast! Thanks for the warning! Aren't there some demons needing your attention?
Give up! Is that true?
No!
When I am finished with you, even if it's the last thing I ever do, I will capture Lisa. I will torture her for the rest of her natural life. Until she begs me to kill her.
Where's Vinaya?
I saw him run after Dagon, who's escaping through the forest.
Find Vinaya. Dagon is too powerful for one angel to handle.
Oh, ye of little faith.
Though I am happy for your victory, I was sure you needed help.
I must admit, for a moment I had my doubts.
Tell us what happened.
The thought of my ward being tortured by that malevolent demon filled me with righteous indignation. And the power that I unleashed upon him was like the fury of 10 warriors.
Fenaya, I'm taken aback by your dedication and love for your ward.
I did what I had to do, Ibrona.
I need a doctor! Where are the doctors?
What happened to her?
She was lost in the forest for like 2 days and she had no water, no food, no nothing. She was just...
Okay.
Is she gonna be all right?
Don't worry, we'll take care of her.
Hey, I'm not sure if you guys remember me.
Jason, right?
Yeah.
We are so sorry.
We want to thank you. Not only did you rescue our daughter, but you saved us.
No, it was Lisa.
I'm Dr. Smith. You must be the McGraths.
Yes, I'm Travis, and this is my wife, Victoria.
And you must be Jason, the brave young man who brought her in here. She's been asking for you.
Is she okay?
Yes, but we do need to keep her a few days to be monitored. It's a good thing you brought her in when you did.
When can we see her?
Yeah, when can we see her?
We're moving her to room 127. She'll be ready for visitors in about an hour.
Thank you.
Sure.
Thank you. Sorry about
that. We weren't exactly ourselves, but you already know that.
I still feel bad about it. I think I'm in love with your daughter.
I guess we were more out of it than we realized.
I hope Lisa will forgive us. I was so mean to her. My poor Lisa.
No, she totally understands, right? All she did was pray that you guys would come back to normal.
Pray?
Yeah, I'll let her tell you all about that. However, there is one thing that you guys can do that would really help.
What's that? Honey, we are so sorry. We didn't know what we were doing.
I know. It's okay. I'm just glad to have you back.
Thanks for not giving up on us.
Is she awake?
Yeah.
This is for you.
Okay.
We all are. Thanks to you.
Communication is the most important thing you can do to move forward and heal your relationship.
I know in my mind that it wasn't Ted's fault. But he said such harsh things to me and the children.
I'm sorry. I had no control.
You two aren't the only ones suffering through this. I've had many couples coming to me with similar issues. It's going to take time and talking things out to heal your relationship.
I'm willing to try.
Me too.
Glad to see you're feeling better.
Maya, are all the demons gone?
Yes and no.
Must you always be so cryptic?
We did have a resounding victory for the Lord, but I'm afraid the demons have not completely left this valley.
So I guess that means my job isn't finished yet.
Your job for now is to heal. May the Spirit light your path.
Mom,
Something isn't right. We need to turn around.
Sweetie, relax. Everything's okay.
Take that.
We wanted it to be a surprise.
Woo! I told your parents not to surprise a demon hunter, but you gotta love them.
Lucky, this is Jason.
Hey, what's up, dude? Heard a lot about you.
I think he likes you.
I think I love you.
I think I love you too.
You.